Kia ora, Mike Cassaidy here, construction manager. You're flying with me today. It's been a little while since I've done the voiceover, and I know we've got a lot of keen followers. So the last one we did was in December, so I think you'll see a little bit of change. Down there is our roundabout, and you can see the tyres were starting to get formed in into the existing road. Just making our way, you can see we've moved the compound from down the bottom there up onto the top, the bridge two or Parahaki bridge compound, and that enables us to get in and do the what we call the gateway park. Quite a neat little area that that'll be the gateway into the gorge walkway and onto the shared use path. There's the compound up on top, and our Parahaki bridge looking like a bridge now. Barriers have been formed up on it. You can actually see the temporary staging, the temporary bridge down there getting removed now, so that's going to really change the look of the structure. Just there you can see on the right hand side the viewing platform is actually jutting out on the upstream upriver side. We're forming up for the expansion joints there. Early March, that big tower crane comes down and unlocks the little bit of what we call land span between the two bridges. That is actually the critical path of the remaining works. So building up that wall, getting the drainage in, building the pavements and asphalting and everything we've got to do across that. A little bit of pavement on that side of the bridge, the eco viaduct's disappearing behind us there, all but the asphalt needs to go on there. Looking down there, you can just see the barriers are starting to go in. The white lines there, they just is done to enable us to pave the final surfacing, which you can actually see those vehicles on there, the final surfacing SMA, stone mastic asphalt. And it gets us so that we pave it and the joins are actually on the lane lines or the painted lines. You can see the stages of planting growing there actually. It's quite a good view of it. And some of these are 3 years old and starting to really establish. And then others were only just getting planted this season. The good old living wall starting to show there a bit of growth on it there. Very early videos, you would have seen the guys building that 30 metre high grid reinforced slope wall. We come up here into the wind farm. This is a pretty majestic view of cut 13. Well, here we go. We've got a bonnet mount camera on this view. You can see that all we've got to do there is actually put the wire rope into the posts there and tension them up, and away you go. Little feature on the left there is a wall there to actually stop water coming off the batters and actually coming across the road there. You can see we're relatively well advanced. In fact, you can see a little bit of a colour change in the asphalt there. This is sort of getting close to where we got the wearing course finished. And you can see the oxidisation going on there with brand new stuff that's just recently paved after about 4 months prior to the other SMA being complete. It's just always cool to come up through the wind farm. That's what the travelling public will see. Right there's a little operation on the right. That's where a new cell phone tower is going in. That's really important to get a good connectivity for the cell phones right through here. There's quite a dead spot in this part of the job, which will be rectified. Great view of some of the meridian access tracks that we've formed up. Obviously we severed quite a few of those. Early videos we were talking about how we had to do the power relocations and everything between the turbines. All just a memory now. Here's the old asphalt plant that'll still be there till early May, and then that gets decommissioned. As we've said previously, that's there in supplying the asphalt along with another one that we have set up in Bulls. Oh, beautiful view of the stream diversions we've built and the beautiful clear water. Now you're getting to the stage in the job about midway. That's Cook Road coming in from the left there. Bridge 5 as we know it, Meridian Underpass. Oh, there you go, good view of going through it. Shared use path on the left hand side there is where it crosses over the alignment. You can see the balustrading work is happening, real finishing touches. And this is where the asphalt team is currently at. Pretty much finished from here to the west, and we're at various stages of finishing the SMA through here. You can see the vegetation well and truly establishing through these areas. As I've said in previous videos, it's just super important we work our way from the outside in so that all the works is finished and we don't have to go back to it. And you can see it's all growing and looking awesome. You can see the shared use path is switched sides here. It comes down. Some of this is still to be sealed and it's just ready to be to surface there. Here's a good view of our wire rope team. Real pioneered on the Huntley section of the Waikato Expressway was a driven sleeve system. Where we drive the sleeve in and then the post goes into that, and, as opposed to like a bored concrete solution. Means we can get quite a lot in quite quickly. And these guys got three crews here working, so it's all about trying to keep ahead of them actually with shoulder work and the median there. As you can see, we've paved down the median there so that enables them to put those driven sleeves in. Again, you can see white lines painted on the surface of the structural asphalt so that we can pave to those. Nice little view of Woodville in the distance. Coming into the Papa cuts, and you can see all the different treatments we're applying to those to either lock in the surface of the batter or stop it fretting. Different solutions there. The brown is actually a progranic, like a sprayed media that grows vegetation, and then the black matting goes over the top of that. The 7 million cubic metres of earthworks, roughly 7 million anyway, that we did in the first three seasons just gave us, got us into a position to be able to get the road on target for its completion date. Now we're really going for it to do these final touches. We've just passed over spoil sites there, and all those spoil sites had huge sediment control ponds and things. We've basically got closed out virtually all of those now. You can see in this shot, it's just the shoulders, the final touches, and then we put that final surface layer on. Cool feature out to the right, we see many of these through the job. These are tertiary treatment, so that all the runoff from the road goes into the network drainage, ends up in those ponds for treatment. We celebrated just with our fencing crew 20 kilometres of fencing the other day, but we've actually still got quite a bit to go, which will happen over the next few months. The Manawatū stream bridge that used to have a ford going over it where that ute's parked by that rock. That's all been removed now, and looking a picture there, so final surfacing across that's all that's required. I do sometimes forget to mention how that the speed of the vehicles that you see in this flyover are actually sped up. See that there? There's a 30 kilometre speed limit on site and 10 kilometres past people working. So when you see those things buzzing around, it's because the whole video is sped up. Coming up here is the Eastern Roundabout. Critical phase of the project is to get these tie-ins into the existing. Quite a bit of work is needed to do that. And we've actually closed this section and got a detour in place to do it. When this was flown, it was day one of that closure. So you can see we're already cutting into the existing road and starting to do drainage and all that sort of stuff. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed the update, and we'll catch you next time.